Hey, this is a tip on the best format for a hard drive if you're working with both Mac and PC. Now, by file format, I mean the file system. The very short version to this is exFAT is the best file system because both operating systems can read and write to it, and there aren't many limitations on the types of files you can store on the drive. If you want to format a drive to exFAT, it's quite easy. You just right-click on the drive, go to Format, and we just change the file system there to exFAT. The allocation unit size I will just put on default. Maybe I'll put a link in the video description to explain that if you want to mess about with that. And then all we need to do is click Start to format the drive. Obviously, this is going to wipe all the data on the drive, so be certain that there's nothing on there you want to keep before you format the drive. And once that's done, that's it really. The only other thing that I thought I would mention is that both macOS and Windows, they save files to the drive that are invisible from one operating system to the other. So on macOS, when you open folders and when you save certain file types, there are some invisible files called, the file name is .ds_store. Now, a lot of these files just contain the position of Windows and various things that the operating system uses to track where files have gone and come from and things like that. And Windows has a sort of equivalent. It uses, I think they're called .thumb, and they're like the thumbnail cache to folders that contain images. The files on Windows aren't generally an issue because they only affect folders that are full of images, and there's only one .thumb file, so it's generally not a problem. But the files on macOS are more of a problem when you read the drive on Windows because the .dsstore files tend to be all over the drive. But I, my computer's quite old, my Mac, and it's running 10.7, but there's a utility on there called Hidden Cleaner, and this will help remove the .dsstore files every time you eject the drive. Now, these files aren't that important for macOS. Like I said, they just contain like the positions of Windows and things like that, and generally don't cause much of an issue if they're removed. So I'll cut to my Mac and show you how that's done. Like I said, this utility is running on my old Mac on 10.7, but it probably does work on newer versions of macOS. Anyway, so I'll cut to the Mac and I'll show you how it works. Okay, so I'm here on my Mac. I'll just open up the hard drive. It's obviously the same hard drive. And we'll just change the view options here and mess about a bit in some of the folders just so that these DS store files are created. So this program here is called Kilometer, and this will allow me to view visible files. And these are the files that you'll see on the drive in Windows. So if I just open up the folder I looked in, and you can see there is a .ds store file been created in there, and again another one in that folder there. So these are the files that we're going to be removing, and this is very easy. The program's called Hidden Cleaner. I'll go back to the PC in a bit and I'll show you the website where I found that. And all you do is literally take your drive and drag it onto Hidden Cleaner's icon. It may take a while depending on how many files you have on the drive. My particular drive does have a lot of files on it, something like several hundred thousand, so it takes a little while to eject the drive because basically it's checking through every folder looking for those .dsstore_files, and it's removing them before ejecting the drive. So this hopefully won't take much longer. I'd imagine a few more seconds. There we go. Okay, so I'll now switch back to the PC and we'll see if those files have been removed. Okay, so I'm back on the PC. I plugged the drive in. Let's open it up and have a look. Okay, so the first thing to just briefly mention is that the root of the drive may still contain some of these files. And these files, I would recommend leaving them there. There is, you might see a .trashes folder. That is actually the trash can that is on the Mac. So if you put something in the bin on the Mac, but then you deleted the .trashes folder in Windows, you're effectively deleting your trash can from the drive, and that might cause some issues. And also you may want to at a later date take something out of the trash and you can't because you've removed the folder. So bottom line is, leave the files that look a bit weird on the root of the drive. They're fine to leave as they are, but the tool should have scanned all the other folders. So let's have a look. Yep, the .dsstore file's gone, and the .dsstore file is gone there. Now obviously you could just manually remove these if you want. It's up to you. And the program is quite old. I managed to find a snapshot of it on archive.org. I'll put this link in the video description. This is from 2018. And you can download the tool by clicking here. This will download the zip archive. Just need to expand that on the Mac, and that will give you the app that you can drag and drop your drives onto. Again, this is an older program. I can't see it having an issue on a newer version of macOS, but it may well do. So just, you know, use with caution. Just make sure your files are all where they should be. Okay, and that's pretty much it. The only thing I might sort of just quickly mention is the other formats that you could use between Mac and PC, but there are some limitations. So FAT32, which is what most memory sticks will be formatted as, is fine to use between the two. But FAT32, you can't have files that are bigger than 4 gigabytes on it. And it also has a limitation with the file length, file name length, and the folder path length. And that can cause some issues. And there's also FAT16, which has even more limitations, not worth mentioning because it's a very old file format. And NTFS. So NTFS is your kind of standard format for a PC hard drive. macOS can read that, but it can't write to it, at least I don't think the current versions can. There are tools out there that say that they'll make NTFS work, and they sort of do, but in my experience they've been a little bit dodgy and I don't really trust them, and exFAT is the much better alternative, so that's why I recommend exFAT. And that's it really. Hopefully this video has been useful to you. If it has, please give me a thumbs up, or if you'd like to subscribe to see more of this sort of thing, please do that. Thanks for watching.